Good day to you, my fellow traders. Today we're going to do some robustness testing on the Bitcoin QQE strategy that I shared previously. To recap, this strategy operates on the 15-minute Bitcoin USD chart. Longs are triggered when the QQE is above 65, with a simple ATR-based stop loss and profit target. Shorts are the opposite. The complete guide to this strategy is linked at the end of this video. Results were satisfying, except that there was substantial deterioration between the in and out of sample portions of the 7-year backtest, hence the need for subsequent robustness testing. First up will be out of sample testing on different timeframes. Since the strategy trades on the 15-minute timeframe, I will retest it on the 5 and 30-minute timeframes. The more timeframes the strategy is profitable on, the more robust it is. But if you go too low, like the 1-minute timeframe, the random noise will likely kill your strategy, or if you go all the way to the daily time frame, your sample size will be small. For this case, I want both additional time frames to have profit factors of at least 1.2. Let's run the test and superimpose all three equity curves. As expected, the original 15-minute time frame performs the best, since more curve fitting is present. The orange line is the 30-minute test, which also performed acceptably. Of greater concern is the first half of the 5-minute test, which suffered a substantial drawdown. Strategies generally perform worse on very low time frames, since transaction costs make up a greater portion of any price swing you're trying to capture. Fortunately, the second half of the backtest went well, so the profit factor condition still passed. Looking at all three time frames, the earlier years have consistently performed worse. I suspect this is due to the static $20 spread used throughout the backtest. As of July 2024, $20 is about 0.03% of Bitcoin price. Back in May 2017, however, when the backtest began, Bitcoin was only trading at $1,600, meaning a $20 spread was over 1% of price. In fact, looking at Duchascapi tick data, spread in May 2017 was $2.80, while the spread in June 2024 was $56, confirming that a static spread corresponding to current prices will penalize performance in the earlier years. Ideally, the spread could be modeled as a percentage of price, which can produce more reliable backtests for volatile markets. Now let's run some Monte Carlo simulations. Since markets are always evolving, the original backtest will never be exactly replicated in future. Even if statistics like win rate and payoff ratio are identical, a different trade sequence will result in a different drawdown profile. By randomizing the trade sequence, we can generate multiple equity curves, each with a different maximum drawdown. Let's set up the Monte Carlo simulator with 1,000 simulations. Exact here means each trade will only be sampled once, so the ending equity will remain unchanged. For passing criteria, I want the return over maximum drawdown, or RDD, at the 95% confidence level to be at least half of the original. The original RDD is 10.32, so for this condition to pass, no more than 50 simulations can have RDD values below 5.16. The multiple equity curves show up alongside the original blue one, and the RDD at the 95% confidence level is more than half of the original, so the test passes. Of course, you can use any metric you like for the passing condition and amend the views here to show it. So now we have some assurance of this QQE strategy's robustness. Like I mentioned in the previous video, I'm incubating this strategy on a demo account. After a couple of weeks, it has placed 4 trades, only one of which was a winner. I'll continue incubating it for a few more months and see how it pans out. To find out how I generated this strategy, check the video at the top. To learn more about Monte Carlo simulations, check the video at the bottom.